Good Wednesday morning, everyone. How's your day going? I'm off to a good start. I got my coffee here. I'm talking to you. And that is what makes my day, really, not just the morning. And I love this chapter that we come to today. It's called How Real Servants Act. It's chapter 33 in the Purpose-Driven Life book by Rick Warren. What on earth am I here for? Subtitle. And that's what we're talking about. The reasons that God still has you here on earth, and this is a big one, it's to serve other people. Jesus came to serve, he said, and he wants us to follow in his footsteps and be servants of other people. In Mark chapter 10, verse 43, Jesus said it right out. Whoever wants to be great must become a servant. That's the first verse in this chapter. And if we don't go much further than that, it's a good day. It's a challenge. It's a challenge because honestly, this whole concept is anti-culture that you and I live in. This culture says, get as much for yourself as you can. Work hard, be good, but not for altruistic reasons, but for yourself, so I can be happy and enjoy life. Jesus said, we serve God by serving others. And if we want to be great in his kingdom, learn to be servant of all. And we're going to end today. This is going to be a good day. We're going to end with that song. And it's inspiring. It touches our heart. So this is a pretty long chapter. I really encourage you to read all the details on what a real servant is. We might touch on one or two. But Rick has a whole bunch. And they're all good. They're all good. Jesus measured greatness in terms of servanthood. We've talked about shape the last few days. And all that was about is how God has made you individually so that you can most effectively serve him by serving others in your shape. So those are very valuable lessons that we had. But in this chapter, Rick talks about how servanthood should be. And he does say on that shape, halfway through the second page, that talks about our primary ministry should be in the area of our shape. However, he says, we have a secondary service that basically says, I'll serve wherever I'm needed. And both are important and make us effective. Now, I got to say at this point that I've never been in a church with more servant-hearted people ever in my life. So I just love being a part of Saddleback Laguna Woods. And the servanthood, the servant attitude is so prevalent. I'm honored to worship with such a group of people. And if you're in another church, I'm sure it's good also. But we're not really talking about what everyone else does. We're talking about what you and I do anyway. And the important thing is that we are servants. Our servants, ourselves. And this list of that what Rick qualifies real servants. They're available to serve. They pay attention to where the needs are. I love this. Did you see the quote from John Wesley, the great Methodist hymn writer? But he said his motto was, do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all times you can, to all the people, as long as you ever can. What a life of service that must have led in John Wesley's heart. Rick goes on, real servants do the best with whatever they have, and they do it with every dedication. They're faithful to their ministry. They get it done. If there's a need, they get it done. I want to just close with the last verse that Rick has on here, the last page, verse to remember. This would be a great one to memorize. If you give even a cup of cold water to one of the least of my followers, you will surely be rewarded. And in that same passage, he talks about if you gave a cup of cold water to the least, you gave it to me. We serve Jesus by serving others. We're going to close, and I just pray that this song will be our prayer, maybe our closing prayer for today's show. Listen and make it your prayer. May God bless you, and I'll see you again tomorrow.